Thanks so much for listening. We hope you enjoyed this message brought to you by Friday Night Light Ministries. For more information, check us out on the web at FridayNightLight.us.
So you know how it goes. We do what the Spirit tells us, and it's different every week. And we're okay with that. Yeah. All right, our vision here. We create environments where people encounter Christ and are empowered to advance the kingdom. Amen?
Amen.
And our mission, let's say it together. I know we've been doing this the last couple weeks, but I think it's pretty cool, so we can just pound it in our head. We gather in His
presence.
Grow in His
power.
Power. Oh. Yeah. Come on, guys. We grow in His power, we go in His light. Close enough. Yeah, it is right behind me. All right, and our mandate. Who knows our mandate? This one's kind of tough. We haven't been saying it as long as the other two. We're going to know God like God as Father like never before. We're going to bring family back to the church, and we want to blur the lines of denominations. Yep. And that's what makes us different, right? All right. So if you're new here, I don't know that I see any new faces, but if you are new, or those of you who are not new, in case you didn't know this, our Connect cards are in the back. Pretty soon we're going to have them on the back of the chairs so that they'll be easy to grab. If you guys do see anybody that's new and we may or may not have had time to get to them, just grab a Connect card and connect with them, make them feel like a part of our family here at FNL, because that's what we want everyone to feel like. Those are in the back. When you get done filling them out, you can just put them in the prayer box, or the giving box, sorry, or either one of the giving boxes by the doors. All right. Make sure you guys are checking in on Facebook to let us know that you're here. We don't count here. However, we do like to know who's coming and who isn't. Actually, mostly just who is. And who isn't. Because if you miss, we want to tell you guys we missed you. All right, so what are we learning in FNL Kids? FNL Kids, we are talking about, our series is called Endgame after the superhero movie that's coming out this month, if you follow those movies. We're learning about Daniel 3 in the fiery furnace. I'm sure everyone knows the story. Today, I only talk about kids the most because, hello, it's like my favorite. And I know what's going on because, whatever, I have to do it all week. They're making little signs. They're like closed, like, you know when you see a store, when it's open or closed, they have the sign that they can flip. So they're talking today about how they have the power to open and close doors to the enemy, and how they can keep those closed, or what things they may be doing that they're not aware of that are opening doors to the enemy. So they're all making closed signs today to put on their doors, which I thought was super cute. Illumination. This is our youth ministry. If you have or know of any students, high school students, middle school, high school students, tell them to come to Illumination. It just keeps getting better and better. We did a scavenger hunt a couple weeks ago. It was awesome. Everybody had so much fun. The kids were going out and evangelizing. I don't even know if they really realized that they were evangelizing, but they were. They were giving stuff away, praying with people, asking people if they needed prayer. And these are kids that you would never think would ever talk to strangers. But they did, and they did awesome. We just had Illumination on Wednesday, and worship was great. Aaron does our worship on Wednesdays. He did an awesome job. The kids are really starting to grow and get into it and connect with each other, so it's awesome to see. Our next get-together is going to be Saturday, March 23rd at 6:30 here at the barn. So like I said, if you know any kids, send them our way. Upcoming events, we have G3 and WOW, Women of Warfare, which is our men and women's groups, happening this Tuesday and Wednesday. G3 is always the first and third Tuesday at 6:30. Oh, look at that. It's up there. And the women's ministry group is the first and third Wednesday of the month at 6:30. All right. As usual, we had our FNL Reload video. Although Wednesday, I think Facebook was having issues. So it posted on some people's, it didn't post on some, yeah, but if you go to the page, you can find it. Yeah, if you go to our Friday Night Light page, it is on there. Kara, it posts new videos every Wednesday for some midweek pick-me-up. Like them, share them, use them to get you through the week till you can come here on Friday. Okay, make sure you guys join band. This is our platform of pretty much everything FNL. there's what they look like. So if you have iPhone, it looks like the one on the left. If you have an Android, it looks like the one on the right. So,
or if you do it on a computer, it's also
or the desktop, right? Or the laptop, whatever, is the one on the right as well, correct?
Yep.
I don't have it on that one, okay. And you're gonna join FNL Maine to keep up with everything we're doing, events, prayer requests, or to add prayer requests or praises. You can find us on social media, Facebook, YouTube, are both Friday Night Light. Instagram is The Friday Light. There it all is. So make sure to take a note or just get on and add us real quick to keep up with us throughout the week. And I'm passing this off. Kara, do you want this up here?
Yeah, sure.
Hey guys. Okay, couple things. Now, we have been praying all month from starting on Thursday at 7 p.m. to Friday at 6 p.m., 24-hour prayer. So we have some sign-ups already. If you want to sign up for your last spot, if somebody takes it, you can put your name in there. We can have two people praying at the same time. It's fine. Lexi plays at 3 a.m. Shane and I pray at 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. So if you guys want to sign up for 24-hour prayer, we just really believe that this is a huge game changer for us. So please pass this around if you'd like to sign up for. And you don't have to pray here. Just pray in your house. It's fine because it'll be cold here tomorrow. So now I shared a couple weeks ago about our parking lot, right? Because it's like kind of a mess. Am I right? I'm right. So, we were expecting a huge quote for like $40,000 on doing the parking lot. And it came in at $15,000. Hallelujah and praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, I'm just letting you guys know. And it asked Shane for like better details, but like the whole driveway, all the way here, back to the pool, around the side here, like the whole thing, 6 inches down with sand and crushed asphalt, all this stuff. So right now we have just over $5,600 saved for that. So we're saving every week for that. And if you feel led in your heart to give towards the parking lot, you can do that. Just write parking lot on the envelope or if you go online to tithe link. So Proverbs 18:16 says, a man's gift given in love or courtesy makes room for him and brings him before great men. So a man's gift given in love. So we never want to recommend anybody gives out of obligation. We want you to give into this ministry or whatever ministry you believe in out of love and courtesy because God lays it on your heart, right? Because when we do that, when we give out of love, it makes room for him. It makes room for him and it brings us before potentially great people, which I think is awesome because God has great plans for us. And so if we're giving out of love, if we're giving out of courtesy, he's going to bring us before great people. And those great people can help us accomplish the plans that he has for us. So, I just want to thank you for giving into FNL. There are three ways you can give. You can give online at through FridayNightLight.us, or you can, there's some boxes in the back you can give, check, cash, credit card, whatever works best for you. And we appreciate it. We use it wisely. We're saving every week for that parking lot. We're super excited about it and looking forward to it. Really excited that
yes.
The number is like so much lower than we thought. So praise God for that. And like I said, if you have questions about that specifically, Shane has more of the details on that because I'm not that kind of person. I mean, I'm a detailed person, but not like construction, that kind of detail. So let us pray for a couple things. Janae and Johnny's niece just was in a car accident, a very severe car accident. So we're going to pray for her before we get started. Her name is Chrissy. And my father was in a motorcycle accident last night, and so we're going to pray for him because he broke his leg really bad, and he's going to have surgery, but can't have surgery for 3 or 4 days, and his neck and fractures and things. So, I know what the devil uses for evil, God will turn around and use for good.
Amen.
So I'm expecting good news to come from this.
Yeah,
and just, so we're just going to pray for my dad, and we'll pray for Chrissy. God, you have plans for these people. You have plans for Chrissy, and you have plans for my dad. You didn't put them here on this earth by accident. You didn't put them here by mistake. You put them here for a plan and a purpose and a destiny, God. And we're saying that you're not done with them yet, God. So we're asking for life to come into Chrissy's body, for no repercussions from this accident to remain in her body, God. We want her walking and healthy and whole and healed from the top of her head to the soles of her feet, inside and outside, God. And we thank you, God. And I don't know what her her status is with you, God, but if she doesn't know you, God, she needs to know you. So send people to her, God, that can bring her into your presence, God. And I thank you, God, for healing my dad faster than the doctors say it's possible.
Yes, Lord.
For that leg to be back to normal because he's active, God, and I thank you for showing up in his life in a real awesome way, God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Good evening.
Evening.
Good evening.
How art thou?
Art thou good?
Thank you.
Art thou good?
Is good, isn't he?
All the time.
Yes, he is.
I don't think it's any coincidence that the song we're singing at the very beginning was written at a specific venue for a specific reason. And I got to, watch the video and how this song came about. And it was out of an utterance of what was going on in the spirit at that time. So we've just heard about Kara's dad, Johnny Janae's niece. Those are some terrible circumstances. It stinks. No fun getting those calls. I remember getting a call when I was down in Tennessee and Aaron was in a hospital bed because he had just gotten hit. I remember getting a call on the way to Chicago about Michelle's dad. I can remember various different circumstances and where I was, even when my other brother, his mom passed away from stage 4 cancer a few years back. There's something that happens when we lift up our voice and we praise our Creator. In the midst of those issues, in the midst of those problems, something happens, something breaks. Something very real shifts in your spirit. I know it's very hard, and I'm not saying I'm Superman. No one is Superman or Superwoman, perfect or otherwise holier than thou. Because I know there's been plenty of times where I have questioned God's plan for me. And I have questioned whether or not what was happening at that moment was supposed to be happening. A lot of the times my mind wraps around the ifs of what I could have done differently. But you can't. You can't change it. I know this, you know this. We have to deal with the now. We have to deal with what happens now. And the now things that we can deal with is our response to those situations, those things that happen that are out of our control. They're out of our control. The things that you can control within your purview, within your immediate sphere of influence that you can affect, you've got to take care of those. But everything outside of that, there's nothing you can do. Kara couldn't have prevented her dad from going out on the motorcycle.
Right.
Johnny couldn't have called and said, hey, don't go out.
Right.
I couldn't have called him unless the Lord had intervened and said, call your brother and say, hey, go. But still the decision would have been his. I've watched some TED Talks, and for what they are, they're good. For for some of them, I'm just like, that's a whole lot of humanist stuff that I'm not 100% behind. But you can control probably about 10% of the things within your world. 10%. That's a very small chunk. And 90% is all about how you respond to those things.
Yeah.
Your attitude, your position. So having the ability to turn your circumstances into an opportunity for praise. If you've never done that before, it's difficult. And if you have done that before, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. I remember my rebirth day is coming up here in 2 days. Yeah, I know. That means it's St. Patty's Day. That's not the reason why it's my rebirth day. That was just the day that I really decided the situations from previous were going to be set apart from the rest of my life and they weren't going to affect me anymore. But I can remember being in the midst of my folks' house and being where the Spirit of the Lord was and sitting in front of the piano downstairs and feeling the Spirit of the Lord come on me so strongly, and I just started playing. And it was flowing out of me. Almost the same thing that happened when David would play for Saul in the courts. The whatever spirit that was on him would leave. And what David was doing would soothe Saul. It would bring peace over his life. There was a breakthrough that happened that day for me. So when you're able to raise a hallelujah, raise your voice, when you're able to raise your hands and praise through those trials and through those tribulations and through those situations, you're sticking it to the enemy.
That's right.
Man.
Yeah.
You're literally, in a spiritual sense, I think about these things, you're spitting in his face and going, you're not even worth my anger. You're not worth my fear. You're not worth me getting upset about. You would take this situation and want to drive me into the ground 6 feet under. But I'm going to go the opposite direction. So when we're able to lift our voices in trial, we're able to lift our voices in situations that look dismal and dim, and have a positive outlook regardless of the outcome. I think that's the issue sometimes. We're expecting God to perform miracles based on our perception of what he's going to do. And a lot of times, as his word says, his ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. We don't know everything that he's going to do. He doesn't reveal his full plan to us. And there's a reason for that. Because we screw things up.
Yeah.
And praise God, I don't know 100% of the story because I don't want to.
Amen.
There are some things in my control that even in that small 10%, I jack it up almost daily. In the 90%, I'm learning how to respond to that. So when we lift our hands, we lift our voices, and we praise God in these issues, the things that are in our lives, even if it's a personal thing that you're dealing with, your heart posture is the most important thing. Remember what God told Samuel when he was going through the line of Joseph's kids. He said, you know, God doesn't look on the outside.
Right.
He looks on the heart. Get your heart right.
Yeah.
Get your posture right. Get before the Lord and raise your hallelujah to him.
Yeah.
That's going to bring more peace. I'll tell you, when I went through the divorce that I had to lift my hands because it was like death. It was so difficult. There's a lot of people in here that know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
God has brought so much better in my life since then.
Yes,
I was willing to get on my knees and raise my hands.
Yes.
I was willing to put my life on the line for what He wanted to do. And He in turn blessed me and has continued to bless me. Aaron praised through his trials. I've walked with this brother for a long time. I know we all have ups and downs, and I was there when he was questioning whether or not God was really in this pain and really in this thing, because he couldn't play guitar. He's playing guitar again.
Yeah.
Yes.
He is singing again. He is leading worship again. There is greater anointing now than there ever was, because he is willing to praise until there is breakthrough and praise and raise a hallelujah in the midst of all of that. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for breakthrough. We thank you for being able to lift our voices to you, being able to understand that we do not have to have the answers. We just need to have a posture about allowing you to move whenever and wherever and however you want to. It's not about us controlling every single thing. We need to learn to lay it down. We need to learn to just praise your name and be happy with whatever the outcome is. We need to have a hope that you have the outcome that you desire. We can't make an outcome happen. We can't. Only you can. You lead us and we will follow. If we're just paying attention to how you're doing things, being aware of how you're doing things, allowing you to work through us, then screwing up is off the table as long as we're following your spirit.
Thank you.
troubled mind. It's not anxious. It's not the restless kind. Thank you. human words are incompatible with your goodness. Because we can't describe just how good you are. Saying that you're good just doesn't cut it. Saying you're wonderful just doesn't cut it. You're so much more than that.
Amen.
Human words fail at the description of just how good you are.
Yeah.
Human words fail to describe just how much you're willing to sacrifice to come after us. After all, you did send your one and only Son to die and to be raised again for once and for all to prove that death is not the final chapter. That disease is not the final chapter. Show us glory in our lives that you are sending us. Lord, let us learn to see the glory in the circumstances that you've provided.
Yes, God. Yes, Lord.
Let us see. Let us have the ability to see where your works are about to be performed. Open our eyes. Open our eyes. Open our eyes.
Yes, Lord. Yes, God.
Yes.
We have limited vision here. By the Spirit, through the power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit, can we have our eyes open to greater and greater things.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
There is more. There is more. You've promised. There is more. Father, we want more. We are not satisfied with status quo. Circumstances that are beyond your control, that's the more you're asking for. When you wanted patience, God brings opportunity for patience. When you wanted more faith, God brings opportunity for your faith to increase. When you wanted to know what love is like, God brings you opportunity to love your neighbor, to love your enemy. Said that he never does anything just for no reason. Everything he does has a reason.
Yes.
It's not your job to understand that reason.
Yes.
It is your job to push into him so he can walk you through that reason. Your position, as he says in Scripture, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness.
Yeah.
And all these things will be added unto you.
Yeah.
When you put him first, when you put his purposes first, just like his scripture says, everything else will flow out of that.
If you enjoyed this message today, be sure to like and subscribe. For more messages or to get plugged in, visit FridayNightLight.us.